Hey team, welcome to our home trading shoulder workout. This one's going to be fun. We've got our normal three sets of warm-up. We've got three sets of working. And again, if you want to add intensity, add volume to the working part, which is the shoulder circuit here. Then we've got three sets of the cuff circuit. So it's talking about stabilizing the shoulder. And then we've got stretching at the end. Again, I have three levels. I'll take you through some reps of every exercise and then give you an idea about how everything goes. Let's get into it. So for this one team, what you're gonna need is either two chairs, two boxes, or two kind of surfaces, coffee table and couch, something that you can have beside you and raise onto. You're also gonna need straps or TRX or rings, something that you can anchor something to, basically, for some rowing, flying type exercises, okay? And potentially weight plate or sandbag if you wanna do some weighted stuff. We're gonna start by warming up our wrists. Thank you very much to Pip for these warm-ups. Fingertip push-ups. Just going to the first knuckle where your deadlift calluses are. First knuckle. And you want to keep pressure through the whole movement. And I'm just using my weight, rocking it back and forth to add enough load that I'm warming up, but not so much that I can't push up. And especially on the way down, you wanna fight a little bit, absorb on the way down, so that you get a really nice warm up. Next one is wrist wrenches. So the palm goes flat, stabilize it with the other hand, elbow to floor, rotate through the arm. This ability to rotate is important when you get to things like overhead work. So it's 10 per side. Again, I'm just showing you a few reps of everything so you can decide what you want to do. Now, if any of this causes pain, you just reduce the range, reduce the intensity, or you can just completely take the pressure off and do it in air. That's also fine. Next one is knuckle rolls. Little bit of weight, roll over the hand. So we're kind of looking for a... just warming up. Next one is our normal walkout push-up sequence, and you've got options of things to add in there. You can add anything that you want. I just like having walkout push-up, downward dog, inchworm, and today a bunny tuck in there, just to make sure your shoulders and chest are warmed up. So, walkout push-up. You can add a T push-up. This is a nice place to put it. You can add scorpions. This is a nice place to put scorpions. You can add kickouts. Such a break dancer, yes! Oh. Then we're at downward dog. Bend your knees lots because this downward dog is mostly important for the upper body. Spread through the back. spread through the hands. And then we go inchworm to wherever. Bend knees is fine, hands off the ground is fine. And then we go to bunny tuck. Hands on the floor, any kind of weight forward, any kind of foot lift. Okay? So five walk out push up sequences with whatever you want in the sequence. Make sure you have the bunny tuck in there, that's important because we're trying to warm up and get comfortable with hand balancing. Last bit is dynamic stretching. So we've got arm swings and we'll start with the arm by itself. And then you add the shoulder. The circle starts to get bigger. And then you add ribs. And the circle gets bigger. And then you add the hips. And change sides. Shoulder. So I like to put my hand on the next part to make sure it doesn't move. Sorry, this should just be arm. Now shoulder. Now ribs. Like adding gears to a bike. Each gear provides you length, makes your circle bigger, and hips. So if you had a smear of paint on your hands, you would see. And maybe that's a fun painting project. Got a spare wall somewhere? All right, three rounds of that warm-up. Take your time, especially in the wrist warm-ups, and we'll get started on the shoulder circuit. For the shoulder circuit, you are going to need some sort of box or bench. So I will show you using a box, but it can be a kitchen chair. And it depends what level you decide to go to. So, handstand push-up, a few options. First one is feet on the floor, and it can look like anything really, as long as you get an elbow bend. So here, some kind of elbow bend. You can have your knees straight bent, doesn't matter, one foot off the ground, whatever you want. Just some kind of elbow bend. Okay? So feet are on the floor. From the front, looks like this. Imagine like you're doing an overhead press. So the elbows do flare out to the side and you're trying to use as much of the big, big shoulder shrugging muscles as possible. Option two is feet on a box or step. So we're starting to prop the hips up higher. Okay, at whatever height you want. Option three is feet on the wall. Let's do it over here. Feet on the wall. Wow, as you can see, that's bloody hard. You gotta walk your toes up and down as you go. Woo! It's fine also to do a mix of the different levels, because perhaps as you go through your circuit, you might get a bit tired. Right, so next one So you do 5 of the handstand push-ups. Next one is a scoop push-up. So, option 1's on the knees. Scoop, scoop. Now I want you to imagine you're ducking underneath a wire. Under, up. And stiff. All right, so that's knees. Same thing, toes. Under, up. Okay. On the toes, when you're bringing your hips up after you've done the scoop, make your core fire first. So draw your handles up and that'll take pressure out of your lower back. So the point that I mean is this moment, if my core is off now, it's all going to go to my lower back. So I've got to, handles! Okay? And the next one is to add a pause in. So you're adding a pause in while you've still got the work in your shoulders and not in your chest. For example, pause. Okay? And the pause can be as long or as short as you need. Right. Next one is plyometric push-up for 3 reps. So, knees. Right? Absorb through the hand. There should be no impact, okay, from the front. Okay, 3 of those. Option 2, plyometric push-up on the toes. Option 3 is a Superman. This is hard. Here we go. You require the whole body for this, so you're going to use your legs. Okay. Hands fly out in front. Woo! You got to get some good height on that one. Otherwise, you don't land it. All right, next one is a traveling handstand. So you can start with your knees or shins, and this is where you need a chair or a box or a fit ball. So knees or shins. Knees would be like this, and traveling handstand, you're just pivoting around. And every time that you move is a rep. So we just want 10 movements. If you want to do shins, you just have your shins on something. This is a bit ouchy. We put a towel on, okay? Next one is to do it in height on a surface. So, for example, up into a pike. Try to get your hips above your hands, and then we are traveling. Okay. Now, the next one is a handstand walk. So if you're feeling bold, then you try your handstand walk. Now, go in this direction. Okay, handstand walk. Ah, damn it. It's so hard to get into. Where's Reed? Need Reed to demo this. Or Pip. And you need to bail, then you bail. Handstand walk. I got to work on that one. All right. Next one is crab walks. So, crab walks, what did I mean by that? Oh, crab walks. Option one, hips low. Every time you move is one rep. Okay, medium. Oh, sorry, high. A high crab walk is here. We're trying to get your hips in line with your shoulders. And then the weighted one, you put some weight on your hips. Okay, so three rounds of that. If three rounds and you're sort of like, yeah, I'm not too bad, do some more rounds. Righto, so now we're going to go into the cuff circuit. First exercises around the world. So, these are a nice exercise I just do generally. So your hands go to wherever they go to. Keep your ribs heavy and draw your hips up so that you've got a squash bug kind of neutral flat back. And then the arms just slide along the floor. And it doesn't matter if they go all the way down or all the way back. This is just, we're just seeing what's possible. So this is level one. Level two is you do this on your tummy. All the principles are the same. Hip handles up, ribs down. So you feel like you're almost like a caterpillar, you're like a worm. Okay, and then we're going from here. Okay, so the last one is weighted. You don't need much weight for these, so any little hand weights, weight plates, cans of soup are really good. Okay. So same thing, handles, ribs. Okay, so 10 of those. Then we're up to the ring strap row. Is where you spread the chest and the elbows, getting in line with the shoulders. So if somebody found your knobbly base of neck bone, that knobbly bone, you're trying to squeeze that knobbly bone. You're trying to squeeze your shoulders into the knobbly bone. So it's very high, upper back and rear shoulder row. Okay? The next one is a stop sign. So, palms down, and you flare up and back. So as soon as you start to pull, you're also lifting, and my arms should look like a stop sign, the bottom of a stop sign. So that kind of, gosh, I can't remember what shape it is. How many sizes does a stop sign have? Six? Hexagon? And you can see really open chest to try and get the back of the body quite tight. Level three is a low, mid, high and raise row. So what that looks like is a low row is almost like a press down. My shoulders will be dropping. So once again, low, keep tension as you come back, mid, high, and then raise, low, keep tension, mid, keep tension, high, keep tension, raise. Okay, so there are three levels for the strap TRX row. It doesn't matter if you've got a belt, if you've got an Oki strap, whatever you're using, just make sure it's anchored onto something stable and that it's strong enough it's not going to break. Next one is our plank drawing. Now, I'll just grab a whiteboard. Right. So along with my handstand fails, you can tell these videos aren't edited. But I got things I got to work on as well. Alright, so plank drawing. Make sure a corner of your plank is in. First level is knees. So you want to keep, it shouldn't look, from behind it shouldn't look like I've got a hand off. It should just look normal, right? I take a hand off, nothing changes. And then you start drawing. Hey, you draw anything you want. A big smiley face. I'm so happy doing my workout. Yay, okay? And then you would do 20 seconds per side. The second option is to do a plank drawing on the toes. So again, from the front view, if I do this well, it shouldn't look like anything's changed. Should look like a normal plank, right? Here, nothing's changed. Okay, and then we're drawing. Okay, 20 seconds per side. Option three is to do a two-point drawing plank. For example, setting up all 4 points. Take a leg off, shift the weight, take an arm off, and now you're drawing. So again, nothing should change, okay? 20 seconds per side. Next one is a pike hold. This is where you'll need two boxes or two chairs or the coffee table and a chair. So, there we go. First option is a forearm. Forearms, so make sure you're really tight in. Forearms, push the ground away. If this feels good, draw the handles up and lighten the feet. If this feels good, pike. 10 second hold, okay? If all that goes well, you can go to level two, which is on the elbow. So give yourself a little bit more space. Okay, so now we're starting to spread the anchor point further away, which means the shoulders have to work harder. So now it's more down through the elbow. And again, press, lift the chest, draw the handles up if that goes well. Pike. Woo. Okay. Lucky last one. I'm going to prop these up a bit more. Okay. So this one is more distance, and now we're on the hand. So the anchor point again gets further away, and it gets harder on the shoulder. Okay, so in the middle, getting some pressure, pressure down, chest up, handles up, and if you're ready, pike. Ah! Sometimes it doesn't work. So, for me, this level is a bit too hard, but we see what's possible. All right, so pick a level that you can do well, that you're not going to bust yourself with, and do 3 rounds of the shoulder cuff circuit. Today is a bit of stretching. So, starting with rear shoulder stretch. This is also nice if you grab a door frame or another person. Drop this shoulder down and then draw it across. And that's lovely. Now I'm just going to show you a bit of each stretch, but I want you to hold them for 60 seconds in total per side, and you can split them up to two lots of 30 seconds. So you can do two rounds. Drop the shoulder, draw across. Pec in front of shoulder. You can get a partner, or you can go to a wall. And just one hand on, and turning away. Elbow in line with or a bit lower will do pec major. And then if you go higher, does pec minor, which is lovely. We would have used a fair bit of pec minor in today's session, so I really recommend doing this high one. 30 seconds per side, done two times. And then external rotation, so you will put your hand on a door frame or a wall, and then you start to turn away. So see if you can keep the elbow in the same place in space and you turn your body. And then internal rotation, one hand on your back, and then you're just drawing this arm forward. And you can, again, rest it on something. For example, just here, and then gently draw it forward. So it sort of looks like it gets folded into your body. Now these internal and external rotation stretches are quite intense, and they're quite specific to an area, so be careful when you do them. And the last one is mid-back, so you can grab onto something and sit back, or I like to grab under my own knees, then sit back. And so we're trying to stretch here through the mid-back. So push that, that's your thoracic spine, so push your thoracic spine, your chest, pull your chest away from your knees. Okay, awesome. So have a great time doing that workout. Please let me know if there are other areas that you want to work, other movements you want to try. I am most certainly going to practice my walking handstands. Have a great time.